probably 15, 18 buildings in here. All cheap 2x4s, glass built junk, you know. Fire traps.
And its original
but
name was
I have to tell you a little story about it. When I worked there, I was in high school doing bungs, wooden boats.
Oh, really?
Right. Yep. I put thousands of them in one summer. And during that summer, if anybody smoked in those buildings, I got caught. It was a 3-day layoff, no pay. But they had upstairs toilets up on the roof. Windows were open in the summertime, the smoke billowed up. And then before that, what did I have? A 25, and I had a 23, and a 16. I built a 16-footer kit boat. That was fun. I also built a 14-footer.
Wow.
So, and a couple of whalers.
Yes.
Yeah, that's got great space stuff.
Gotta have a lot of boats, you know. The one before this was a 40 Constellation, double plank bottom, and it was built right here at Algonac. Almost the same layout.
Yes.
Had same engines, 427s. I bought it right over here from Colony Chriscraft at the time. It's now called Colony Marine.
Yep.
Pete Beauregard's the owner.
Uh-huh.
And it was being bubbled in a shed that was open in the front. I bought it in February, went up there about 5 days after I bought it, or paid for it. The ice had built within about that far of the hull. And I said, I'm never gonna have a boat bubbled again, never. And I didn't. That had everybody scared because they were, I think the power went out for a day,
huh?
And of course the pumps went out, you know. They lost one over there, 45 Constellation, about a year later, same thing,
huh? Yeah.
Corinthian was built down in Maryland.
Okay.
And I had that for 3 years. That was a new boat.
Okay.
It had the smooth sides. And
yep.
Lap straight bottom. That was a neat boat. I liked that boat, but it was wet. And you'd hit a 2-foot wave and the water would come right up over the top. Yeah, it was smooth. The boat wanted to run about 22, 23 mile an hour all the time. And if you went slower than that, it seemed to lug down, you know. But it was a good boat. We ran it probably 100 hours a year. That was a kind of a secret deal in the beginning, but when they took it to that New York boat show, that put a lot of interest in it because I think fiberglass was coming into its real being at that time. Chriscraft kind of copied the wood boats in a way.
Right.
You know? And they just built things pretty heavy duty and made sure. They didn't know really what it would take. As you can look around here, you're going to see a few little cracks here and there. Went up by the windshield on the right and left, port and left and starboard side. They've been there as long as I've had the boat and they've never opened up anymore. So
yeah.
As long as they don't break open on the bottom, I guess we're okay. Yeah, I thought about it. I was going to sell this one about 20 times and get a 30 footer. I always liked that Sea Ray. That was because it was.
Oh! Cut! Cut!
Every time I threatened about selling this boat, my wife Helen would say, "Yeah, you're gonna get a bigger one. You want a bigger boat, like a 47. I said, "Yeah, you know, I kind of like that." She said, "Well, you can't have that. You'd be satisfied with this one." So I kept it. She liked the boat. She always liked this boat. Of course, the interior has always been her job, and she handled the decorating. It's been redone 3 times down there, new carpeting. It's ready for another one, but every 10 years we do that. January, latter part of January, It was over at a place called Blue Lagoon near Mount Clemens on the Clinton River. And they tried to sell the boat at that time. They never had any takers. It was kind of a bad market that year too. So I didn't like the price that they were asking either. So I had a friend that was a salesman there, and back in January, that came around to January, and he called me up and he says, "We cut the price." I said, "How much did you cut it?" He said, $10,000. I said, "What for?" "Well, we want to sell the boat, you know." And he said, "Why don't you come out and talk to me some more?" Went out to the showroom. It was cold. God, I don't remember how cold it was, but it was around zero. And I said to this fellow, his name was Dick Voorhees. He said, "You going out and take a look at it?" I said, "Yeah, you coming along?" He said, "No, it's too damn cold out there." Went back in and I said, "Dick, you cut $10,000 out of it. How much more can you cut?" He says, "I can't cut any more." I said, "That's rock bottom." I said, "I'm going to tell you what. I'm going to give you an offer right now, in writing, and you've got to accept it within an hour." He says, "I can't cut it." I said, "Well, who can? Where's your boss?" He said, "He's down at the other store in St. Clair Shores." I said, "Call him up and tell him this is it, including sales tax, the whole bailiwick, and you've got to give me a compression test on the engines when it goes in the water, and then I pay you the last $2,000. Okay, picked up the phone, called. "Yeah, this guy wants to give me this many dollars." The guy says, "Take it."
So, then you knew you went too high.
That's exactly right.
I was stuck.
That's right. Damn.
So I went home and I told my wife, she wasn't going with me out there, that cold bullshit. And I said, "Well, we just bought a boat." And she said, "Oh." Because the guy hadn't paid me off totally, because I sold the 40 for a chunk of cash, and he still owed, it was $4,000 that he couldn't come up with. And I had said to him, his name was Jack, and I remember that, and I said, "Jack, what else you got?" He says, "I got a piece of property over here on Swan Island. It's a Canadian island over there." This was back in October, because I was ready to pull the boat out the following week. And I said, "Okay, let's go take a look at it." So we went for a boat ride and went up there about 8-9 miles. Looked at the property, and I knew the island pretty well. It's about 80 places on it. And he says, "Well, I got two lots here, this one and this one. Which one do you want?" I said, "I want the one closest to the bridge, because that goes right over to the clubhouse." The value at that time that I put it at on trading with the boat was about $4,000. Uh-huh. It was just a bare piece of dirt. And I ended up selling it about 10 years later for $18,000.
So really? Good.
I never did anything with it.
A wise purchase.
So that was a pretty good deal. And then, of course, that put me into this, you know. That's the story. I kept it at a marina right down here called Bell Harbor, which is now Sassy Marine. And it was a kind of a family place. I think we used this for a weekend cottage every weekend. Every weekend. Our kids were growing up, our daughter and son, and it was a great place to be. Got to know a bunch of nice boater friends. It was just a great deal. So I think those are the best memories on it right there. We had a good time.
Well, that's great. You look pretty cool right there, Captain.